Hello all, in this video we are going to see how can we plot or render data on Google Maps using Google Maps JavaScript API. But before that we'll just do a quick recap of what we did in earlier video. So we exported our data of departments and location from HR schema into departments.csv file and employees table from HR schema into employees.csv file. After that, in main.js file, we using promise.rd3 function, we loaded those two files, those two CSV files, and at once that load gets complete, we call this aggregate data function. So in aggregate data function, basically we are doing the join operation on these two files or on these two data sets. And again, once those files get joined or once data gets combined into this employee JSON object, we are doing some aggregation or aggregate operation on that object, and finally into cities object we'll see how that cities dot object looks. So if I go, so this is how the final aggregated data we see in cities object. So this is basically a array of JSON objects. So it has 7 or 8 different elements. Each element has city, departments, employees, latitude, longitude, and salary attribute. Now this data, these exactly 8 objects, we are going to plot on Google Maps using this latitude and longitude, these values. Now if you Google Google Map JavaScript API, you will come up across this URL. So I will just click over here, and the very first example you will see is this related to Hello World. What I will do, I will just copy paste the code which they have given here. First is a style. Let me go to employees.jsp, and that will be under head tag. Alright. And after that, this div element under body tag. I will place this after this div. Alright. After that, this script or JavaScript is there. I will copy this again and I will add this in our main.js file. Here they have added because they do not have a separate JavaScript file. That's the reason they have combined everything. But in our case, we have main.js separately, or we are keeping our JavaScript file separately. So I will, okay, what I will do is function. Okay, I will add like this only, and I will move this initialization over here. All right. Okay, I will make this in double quotes. Doesn't matter, single quotes or double quotes, it's one and the same. Okay, after that, the only part which is remaining is this script function or this script tag. This refers to actual JavaScript or Google Map API. Now in our case, we do not have to worry about this key. So if you go through this documentation, what they are saying is, first declare the doc type that we had already declared, create a div element that we created, we define a JavaScript function that creates a map, creates a map in a div. So we added this JavaScript function as well. In our case, we added that in the main.js file. And finally, the fourth is, so this is very important script or important step, we load map JavaScript API using JavaScript tag. Now this is exactly what they are referring to. Now here what they are saying is, we have to add click to insert your credentials. So if you create your account on this developers.google.com, and after creating the account, it will definitely ask for your credit card details and all. So after that, you will get this API key. I mean, this Google API key is not free for I mean, for developing purpose you can use it, but if you want to utilize that as a production environment, then in that case it is not free. You will have to give your credit card details, and after that you will be able to log in, or before creating the account itself it will ask you all those details, and after that you will get this key. But in the our case we do not have to worry, we will simply ignore this key. So what I will do is I will just remove this, we don't need this for our case. Okay, and alright, so what they are saying is after this, so we declared all this, we declared this, so this they are saying a zoom level. So if we go back, so this is the 8 is a zoom level, we can change it, we'll see this how exactly it appears. So in our case now somehow, okay, let's do one thing. So I have added this in my code and I will refresh it. I'll close this as of now. So nothing happened, nothing got changed. Let's check the console. Only our console.log, whatever we saw, the array which we printed, that we can see. And another instruction or information we got is no API key. So that is fine, we deleted that particular API, we do not need this. Now okay, somehow we have to call this function which we have added very recently. What we'll do, I will just call this. So however page will get loaded, so once we from our servlet, when requests get redirected to employees.jsp page, it will first load this main.js file. I mean, after loading all these things, it will go for this main.js file. Once it comes to main.js file, it will first load these two CSV files. After that, it will call internally this aggregate data method. And at end of this aggregate data method, we are calling this init map. So let's see what happens now. I will simply refresh it. Yes. So now we are seeing the actual Google map. So as they have mentioned over here, once we add it, you will be able to, it will render the Google map. Okay. Now another thing I wanted to show is where is my Google map. Okay, now for development purpose only, this message we are getting, reason being we haven't added that API key which they are talking about. So only that's the difference. If we add that API key, this will go away. Now our next target is, we do not want to see just this Google API, we want to plot these actual cities to this Google API. Now to plot these things, there is another method called marker. So if I come down and if I see drawing on the map, so basically we have to plot those cities on this Google map which we have rendered right now. So if I click on this marker, so this is actual call. So this is a map method, we are creating a map object. So this is, sorry, I mean this map method we already called. So over here, so we created the map object, and to that map object now we have to add a marker. So to add a marker, there is a method called marker. We are passing these attributes to that, and again this marker is another variable. So what we'll do, I'll copy these things and I will add it below this. Okay, now if you see, this marker method is expecting latitude and longitude. So this is basically a object, JSON object. So I will do one thing, I will initialize this. And I will move all this code. I will create another method called add marker. So function add marker, Alright, and I will just simply copy the code which we got from that page. Okay, now we have to call this add marker method. So how many times we have to, so basically our intention is we have to plot all these cities. So we have 8 different cities, so we have to plot all those 8 cities based on this latitude and longitude. Now we have this latitude longitude data, so if you go back to this, so basically we have this 8 different values for latitude and longitude for 8 different cities. And since we have created or separated out this code in a separate method, we have to call this method for 8 times for each city. So for that, so that city's data, so I will pass this city's data and I will add. So now while calling this init map method, we are also passing this city's object. So basically this object, this data set, we are passing to our init map method. Now we do not, so this data set has many information, and out of that we are just interested in this latitude and longitude objects or attributes. So we have to extract those two attributes, latitude and longitude, and we have to pass those two attributes to this addMark method. So I will keep this like this and I will add a for loop. So we have to iterate to this data set, to these 8 records, for let count equal to 0, count less than data dot length, count plus plus, and since we have defined this variable, I will use this variable. In every iteration I will initialize this variable with blank JSON object, and I will add the values latitude or add the attributes to this object as data cnt dot, so our attribute name is, in this case, let's say lat. I will copy this entire string, and the next attribute is longitude, and I will use this lng. Okay, now I have to call this method, my lat length. Yes. So what this code will do, or what this for loop end of for, so what this for loop will do, it will iterate through this data set, and for all the 8 records it will find out latitude and longitude, and it will pass that latitude longitude object to this add marker. Inside add marker method we are passing this exact coordinates, latitude longitude position, to this position attribute. Map attribute we are already defined, this variable, and title we are giving it as 0. Instead of that we can do one thing, we can pass city name as well. So what we'll do, so along with this I will pass data cnt dot city, and I will pass second attribute city name, and I will give this as over here. Let's see what happens. I hope there are no errors, and I will close this. Okay, yes, so as you can see, okay, let me zoom in. Okay, so let me go back to the inspect. So we had these 7 or 8 records, so 8 different cities. No, this is undefined. So there are exactly 7 cities. As you can see, there are 4 in USA, two in, okay, I have two in UK and another is somewhere here in Germany. Now since we passed this city as a separate attribute to this method or parameter to this method and pass that to title, now if we hover the mouse, it will show the Munich or the city name. This is London, this one is Oxford. So Oxford, London, Munich, and in USA okay, this one is Toronto, so that's in Canada. This is South Lake in Texas, South San Francisco in California, and Seattle in Washington. All right, so that's how we plotted whatever latitude longitude coordinates we got in earlier video of different cities onto a Google map. So in next video we'll see how to render this data as well along with this. So just now we can see just the city name, but we need to plot this employees, department, salary along with this latitude and longitude. So we'll see that in the next video. Thank you for watching this video.